Hello and welcome to my latest video. It's all about empty Sella syndrome. I was diagnosed about 3 or 4 years ago with this condition, and it's where the pituitary gland has been crushed up against the Sella turca. That's the bony cavity inside your skull in which the pituitary gland sits in, protected. And I just wanted to give you a brief rundown of what it's actually like to have empty Sella myself. It's not a nice condition to have, although it is manageable, and I believe that if you're watching this, you probably have also just been diagnosed with empty Sella. Don't worry, things can get better. Once they start sorting out your hormone levels and getting them regulated at the correct levels, finding out what's missing and replacing them, you'll be on the road to recovery without a doubt. Empty Sella itself can affect all of your hormones, from your thyroid to your adrenals. If you're female, your ovaries. For guys, sorry, it's your testicles. Prolactin levels can be affected, and also your growth hormones. So they call the pituitary gland the master gland. It is the case, I'm afraid to say. If you're being diagnosed with empty Sella syndrome, you will either be primary ESS or secondary empty Sella syndrome. For myself, I am, I believe, primary empty Sella, which I think the cerebrospinal fluid has punctured and pushed and collapsed my pituitary gland. Some people are born with it, and it's a condition they manage throughout their lives. Myself, I've only had it 3 or 4 years before this, so I was in very good health. As you can see, there's been a long, long list of things that's affected me, from dizziness, lethargy, loss of sex drive, lack of sensation, hot flushes, racing pulse, putting weight on, swollen face, aching joints, and unable to sleep. These are all things that are brought on by your hormone levels being affected. It's not very pleasant. As I say, I'm also hyperthyroid. But please, if you are listening and watching this video, don't worry. You can get fixed. We can get better. Or perhaps I should say, we can manage our conditions. So, hey, you know, there's a lot worse things out there. I'm struggling with hyperprolactin at the moment, and I will be looking at trialing out Agnus castus or chase berry to lower prolactin. Also, Mucuna pruriens, the herb, is effective at lowering prolactin via changing dopamine levels. I'm not an expert, but I will be looking into trialing out these, because cabergoline and all the other dopamine agonists that have been offered just tend to give me insomnia, and I don't feel so great taking them. There are other options, St. John's wort or vitamin B6. There are other options for lowering prolactin. But listen, you know, I'm going on a bit here, but empty Sella syndrome is not the end of the world, and there are places that you can get help. I've got a Facebook page set up if you'd like to visit that and join my group, and I'd love to get chatting with you, and we can discuss ways to feel better and ways to improve the condition with empty Sella. And finally, I just thought maybe we could end on a happy note. Here's a nice beach scene from a webcam that I discovered in Maui. Fantastic, huh? Certainly beats the UK. Take care, guys, and empty Sella syndrome is not in the world.